Our top story, 3 years after TV executive Neeraj Grover was killed and hacked to pieces. His killer, Emil Jerome, a former Navy officer and commando, has been sentenced to 10 years in jail on charges of culpable homicide, not amounting to murder. But Jerome's girlfriend, the aspiring actress Maria Susairaj, is set to walk free as she's been sentenced to 3 years in jail for helping Jerome destroy the evidence and has already spent more than 3 years in jail as this trial was going on.
Guilty of destroying evidence of a brutal murder, yet not too far from freedom. The court has convicted her to 3 years for covering up Neeraj Grover's murder. But she has already spent that long in jail, so a fine of 50,000 rupees is all that separates Maria Susairaj from freedom.
I am thinking that she is not proper state of mind. She is silent throughout the things. She has not uttered a word from her mouth, so I can't comment on her behavior. As she has served the sentence of 3 years, whatever the sentence is awarded, she has served more than 3 years, so she will come out today itself.
Her partner in crime, former naval officer Emil Jerome, faces 10 years in jail for the murder. Both sentences under sharp criticism, given the brutality of the crime and the cold precision with which they covered it up.
Confession जो था वो बहुत अहम था और confession ने ही पूरे मामले को घुमा दिया.
दोनों ने एक जगह पर एक साथ एक crime किया है. अकेला Jerome कर नहीं सकता, अकेला वो 300 pieces कर नहीं सकता. वो तो co-accused है. धारा बदलने का कोई कारण नहीं. दोनों को अलग-अलग सजा कैसे हो सकती है?
For an already distraught family of Neeraj Grover, today's verdict has rubbed salt into their wounds. They feel it was primarily Maria who was responsible for their son's death and had accompanied them everywhere after the murder, pretending to search for Neeraj, giving nothing away.
1.5 lakh rupees is what Maria and Jerome have been fined, money that will go to Neeraj's parents. But like the judge pointed out in his order, no compensation is enough for having lost their only son in such a gruesome manner. In Mumbai, with Saurabh Gupta and Ketaki Angre, Anusya Mathur for NDTV.
Well, let's just go get a quick reaction firstly from Neeraj's father, Amarnath Grover. This is obviously a very difficult time for you, and I understand it's difficult for you to really comment beyond a point in this case, but will you be seeking justice? Will you be approaching a higher court as a result of the verdict now?
Hello?
Mr. Grover, can you hear me?
He
can't hear us. We'll try and fix that line. Mr. Memon, let me come to you first. I just want to reflect briefly on something the judge said. And so let me just quote. Now, referring to Emil Jerome, the judge said, and I quote, "When he entered the room, he was calm. This showed he did not have intention to murder. Obviously, for a fiancé in a situation where he finds a stranger with his partner would upset a prudent man and he would lose control." Sir, a lot of people would want to know if anything justifies a man or a woman losing control to such an extent.
See, first I must tell you that common people since yesterday have started, you know, raising some very pertinent questions, and they are very curious to know that what kind of law do we have. You know, the killers are identified, the dead person was cut into pieces, hundreds of pieces in a very brutal manner, and yet the court says it's not murder. They are asking us the question and we are not able to answer that. Yes, the ultimate finding of the court is that it is not murder, it is culpable homicide, not amounting to murder, as against the prime accused and as against the co-accused, there is nothing except destruction of evidence. Certainly, it's very, very discouraging and very disturbing findings by the Learned Trial Court. But we have unfortunately had no access so far till the reasoning recorded by the learned judge in his conclusions that he has drawn, and also the evidence which is vitally relevant for the purposes of a law person to appreciate. But as we all, as you asked me the question, I must answer that.
Yes.
That, well, we have a provision in law that a person can be given benefit of a grave and sudden provocation, in which situation he may get his reason eclipsed for a little while and his prudence may not operate. Mm-hmm. But I don't think, with highest respect to the learned trial judge, I don't agree with him that that thing applies in this case, because here the murder was not just one stroke. But the murder continues after that. Even dead body was cut into pieces by all kinds of preparation, going and procuring knife and bags and cutting into pieces in most indescribable manner. The murder does not end just when he sees the fiancé in a compromising position. And there, you see, a person who should be entitled to this kind of benefit under law must have such conduct, yes, that if he gets his reason eclipsed, he comes to his senses soon thereafter and then conducts himself in the manner which is of regret and remorse.
Right.
Let this me just does not seem in this case at all.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.